quick introductions. Katniss. These people have come a long way to support the cause. This is Cressida. In my opinion, one of the best up-and-coming directors in the capital.
Until I up and left. Hey.
Hi.
I play Cressida, who is a documentary filmmaker. She comes from the capital. She's turned rebel and joined the rebellion cause. She was originally with Plutarch's underground, so she's come with Plutarch's faction to join District 13 to fight against the tyranny of President Snow.
Katniss, here's what we need to do. We're gonna shoot a series of propaganda clips. Propos, I like to call them, on the Mockingjay.
Plutarch has convinced Coin, who's the leader of 13, that Katniss is viewed as kind of the symbol of the rebellion, and that they can use her and they can create a series of propaganda clips using her as the symbol for the rebellion, that they could stir everybody up and they could unify the districts and they can actually defeat the capital.
What are designed are these propaganda messages, these propaganda films that infiltrate the capital broadcast systems, take them over to advance the story of the rebels and using the Mockingjay, Katniss, as the focal point.
The Capitol has always suppressed communication between the districts, but I know their system very well. I managed to break through.
All we need now is the perfect message. So the Propos are, you know, rebel propaganda, pure and simple.
No one else can do this but her.
This is not the girl you described.
Obviously, we need to make it personal.
Plutarch is convinced that it's got to be, personified in an individual. And That's where the propaganda films and the Mockingjay come together. And Katniss has to get her arms around that and start to understand that she's got to do it.
It's about how battles can be fought. Battles can be fought on the battlefield with a gun, they can also be fought in the media. And that's the really interesting thing about Mockingjay, is where these lines cross over between image and physical fighting.
With energy, go.
People of Pan Am, we fight! We dare to end this hunger for justice!
You've just been in battle! Excuse my outburst. You've just been in battle.
Try it again, whenever you're ready.
In the book, you only see what Katniss sees. But in the movie, we wanted to show what are the consequences of her actions on this larger conflict, and how is it that these propos actually affect the people who are in the districts, and what does that look like?
People of Pan Am, we fight, we dare, we end this hunger for justice.
Well, at first, she's not really good at the propos. She's not really good at scripted things or any kind of manipulation or anything like that.
The opportunities for spontaneity are obviously lacking below ground. So what you're suggesting is we toss her into combat.
Cressida is part of that team that is trying to, I don't want to say manipulate as in giving it such negativity, but it is a manipulation because she is the only person that can galvanize the districts through the Mockingjay symbol.
Let's see what you can do. Be careful.
This is my assistant, Masala.
It's an honor to meet you.
I play Masala, who is the assistant director to Cressida.
We all fled on our own. For this. For you.
We end up joining forces with Katniss and trying to help her show the world what's really going on.
And your cameraman over there, Castor?
Hello.
And Pollux.
Pollux is my beloved brother. We are brothers that work together. He's an AVOX. The Capitol captured him, cut out his tongue, and he had to work underground for 5 years.
And their bond is really tight because Castor saved money for many years to get his brother out from working underground in the tunnels.
And we escaped and joined the rebellion at that point. We have
been assigned to Katniss, and we are kind of documenting her uprising as the Mockingjay and the rise of the rebels against the Capitol Panem.
The Propos aren't going well, the sort of mock ones, and they decide it would be good to go to District 8 and visit a hospital. And what happens is stuff really pops off.
The idea is that through propaganda videos directed by Cressida, that it will stimulate the districts in the rebellion against the Capitol.
She, who is a simple girl from the lowest of the districts, has been able to sort of stand up to the Capitol, that if she can do it, anybody can do it, and she can give the people the courage to fight.
The lumber district, they would rebel by rappelling up the trees and, you know, bombing the peacekeepers below, and that the, you know, hydroelectric dam would get blown. These great ways connect her propaganda pieces to the inspiration of these rebels and the seeing of the world of Panem and what that revolution would really look like.
Don't film me in there. I can't help them. Just let them see your face. Huh? It doesn't turn out to be a purely non-military squad. Obviously, what happens is a lot more exciting than that.
Help! Get them out! Katniss? Katniss, can you tell everyone what you're seeing right now?
I love the idea that she's this director from the Capitol that's like, you know, like a war journalist, a combat journalist of some kind, somebody who's willing to sort of go out into the middle of it all and get what she needs. And she's got this kind of elegance, and she's got this kind of tough, almost kind of punk, irreverent attitude. And, you know, Natalie's tough, she's strong, and she's smart. And I think a lot of that really comes across.
Katniss,
don't make me do this.
Let her go.
There's definitely times where Cressida is like pushing to get something from Katniss in moments where others would just back away and let the person have their space. But, you know, Cressida, being smart, is the one who's like, no, 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 now that she's all charged up, is that's when I'm going to go in and get what I need. And she's not afraid to sort of push people who, you know, could be in quite a fragile state in the story. And I think Natalie does an amazing job at that.
During the filming of the Propos, you see this surreptitious, like, graduation where Katniss feels like she's playing a role. And slowly, almost without, unwittingly, without her realizing, she becomes the embodiment of what she's playing.
She sees just the extent of, you know, the harm that President Snow has caused to these districts, and I think it motivates her to become the Mockingjay.
Plutarch's faith in you wasn't misplaced.
When she gets caught up in what's actually happening, and she speaks from the heart, and she's moved from the heart, this incredible leadership quality that Katniss has comes through in these videos, and she's enormously effective in these propos and what she's doing when she's speaking from the heart and when she's genuinely reacting to what's in front of her.
Katniss, what do you want to say?
I think it's very interesting because when Cressida starts filming Katniss with the Propos, I think she's got quite a cynical, professional idea of what she's trying to create to paste the symbol of the Mockingjay on Katniss. But as she spends time with Katniss and as the story develops, I think Cressida starts to believe in Katniss as that symbol that can unite an oppressed people. And it's a beautiful thing to see.
In each of the films, we've added to the cast. And with Mockingjay, we now have our District 13 world with Natalie, with additional characters that are now helping guide us through the journey and bringing another personality, another type of layer to it.
Eldon and I hit it off right away. I spend the most time with him because we're always grouped together because we're brothers, and he doesn't have a tongue in the movie, got cut off. So we thought it was important to get to know each other so well that we can communicate without necessarily having to speak.
Don't expect much chit-chat from him. He's an AVOX. Capitol cut his tongue out years ago.
We've kind of even came up with some ways to communicate with signals, and we spent a lot of time. We got to know each other really well, and I feel really close to him, and so I do feel like this
relationship is translating on screen, this brotherly relationship and this communication that we have with each other.
It has been a total nightmare working with Wes. I'm just kidding. He actually wrote some things down for me to say. Working with Wes is really, 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 really awesome.
Those two are like my buddies. I don't know what we would do without each other. I keep saying we're like the three musketeers. We don't leave each other's side. They're both two of the awesomest people ever, and they both are like two of my best buddies probably for the rest of my life. Cressida is awesome. We almost have every scene together. We do have every scene together. We're like partners in crime in this, and it's been really, really cool to be able to work with her. I'm a fan of hers, and it's been a really great process, you know?
I was really excited to get to work with her. She's a lot of fun, and she deals with me asking her a million questions about Game of Thrones and getting to talk about that, but it was really a treat to get to work with her because I'm such a huge fan of her.
I think we all been working together. We shoot all at the same time, so we kind of end up hanging out with each other outside of set together and being able to like really get that camaraderie together. It's been really, really good.
You know, everybody seems to just fit so well together. They all complement each other so perfectly, and they all feel like they're part of the same acting group. You know, everybody's making a very special movie and bringing all their many talents to it, and they all just fit together like a perfectly matched puzzle.